Wow.
Save in pristine condition. Since we're avoiding our warranty.
So we see the same X in there.
Is that indeed 10?
Yes. Don't look at that.
How many sockets you got welded together there, Ken?
Two.
For what?
I didn't weld them.
Because we keep on losing the 10 millimeter?
I didn't. I'm not the one that stuck them together.
So this spot near the rear motor mount, it's got like a big gap in it. Definitely looks like it's wanting something to be stuck in there in order to spread it. There's a OEM provision for a spreader right there in that socket to that surface. Well, shucks. Good thing we took the inverter out.
Kind of feel a little bit more resistance on this side.
Is that why they have so many wedge-shaped slots over here? That sounded like a nice slide. Oh, drag. Okay, so make sure that if there's any shims in there, that... No? Is it stuck? Is it stuck to this side? Any shim? No? Anything else to note? Or it's pretty simple. All it's got is that spring, and then the three ports for the phase wires. That's it?
Then I'm confused where this... That looks like it's just locating it. It's just locating off of that hole and that hole, but there are no...
Well, that's just a piece of plastic, so yeah. I think that the O-ring is just kind of giving him some resistance to vibration.
Relatively straightforward when they were pulling it all apart.
Yeah, they said it all came off by hand. So it's the splines to the actual motor. Oh, you know what? They did loosen up this windage strip.
Yeah, you pop that on the back. Mm-hmm. Might be one more in the middle.
You want me to hold that guy while you turn, that guy's blocking him.
Okay, you might be able to get that one out of there.
There's some shiny copper.
Yeah. Okay, mm-hmm. We got that tray off. Almost. Okay.
I'm just gonna be like kind of holding it up and stabilizing.
And then you just want some vibration.
Yeah.
To get that bearing out of the back. I'm gonna tap the case for just this guy.
Big ass bearing.
Got it. Safe. So it keeps most of the oil on the gear, except it has like a little pinhole to let it slowly, you know, sort of circulate.
It's also nice because that means the high velocity oil isn't slamming into the sealed surface. So then you don't really deal with any like additional pressure in there.
Nice.
That's not a lot of force to take that off. That's encouraging. Since it seems impossible to buy another bearing. One unmolested Tesla bearing.
Looks perfect.
So the tool that we were using may look a little ghetto, but the point of what probably wasn't able to be seen before the bearing came off is that we were putting the feet right here in those notches. And when they go in those notches, then they're actually pressing on the center of the bearing, which is appropriate.
They're only identification marks on one side, so we know it goes in the same way.
Okay, so we did find one shim, and it is right here on this side.
Material out here.
Are you trying to grab the inner race without grabbing the outer?
Exactly.
Grabbed it. So on the Tesla diff, we had just a little notch to get the feet of our puller up underneath the race on the inside of the bearing. And here we have the aftermarket LSD and just a way more convenient amount of space in order to get that same thing done. And on the opposite side, this is where we have the bearing splitter getting up underneath the inboard race on the bearing. And we can see that the aftermarket one has just plenty of room in that same area for you to get up underneath it. We just wanted to measure both diffs race to race to see if we'll have any problems with needing to shim for the gear lash.
Yeah, this shim number.
It's the big gear out. Oh yeah. That's pretty wild.
Damn, that thing was hard AF to center.
Well, don't even look at it wrong.
Just, holy crap. Dude, there's got to be a tool or a method to align that motor shaft, but
I wouldn't be surprised if it's like a rear main seal kind of tool, where it's just like a plastic guide that just kind of extends the hole.
It makes sense that you say, if you had the case split and you this side first, that could be definitely a thing.
Okay, so there's a little bearing in here, and then there's a hat for the bearing, and it's got like a little spindle on it, and then that inverted cup on the bearing spacer is going to contact that spring. So should we put that guy in here first? I think so. He looks secure.
There's a chance we're gonna have to pick it up to get past some of these.
So the phase wires are the first thing that we're gonna be stabbing. Phase bars. Next, we got all the bearings, and then finally the dowels are last.
Oh, I gotta take it. Take out those intents.
Just like kind of lift this up.
You on bearings now?
I hold it like this. Does somebody want
to? Just give it some taps. Ooh, it's totally going in. Loves it. Anywhere else? You want this?
Nope.
Is it? Ultimately, we do have bolts. Going into aluminum is 30 foot-pounds.
30 foot-pounds, 40 newton meters.
What?